us, excited for our guys about the opportunity playing the Sweet 16 against a very talented Michigan team. Team that executes as well as anybody in the country on offense. Guys that can make shots, shooting 40% as a team. And actually four guys shooting over 40% and one is about 57-58. Space you out very well. Of course, a well-coached team. They've been in this situation last year, so should be fun for our guys. We're excited about it, but also still very hungry.
How's all day you kind of keep your team a little bit grounded? Obviously, the next couple days are going to be here and doing it, you know, how good they are. And obviously, you guys got all the students here when you got back. How do you kind of keep your team grounded?
Really just stand humble and also make them understand you heard the bad. And the approach doesn't change. And I tell them all the time, whether you're high and low, you have to stay consistent in your approach. We got to continue to take care of the task at hand, work extremely hard. But some things you can't control as a coach, and I think some things are good things. I think as players, you've been knocked down a little bit, so there's nothing wrong with that, in my opinion, as long as you're still playing the level you're capable of playing at. So I think on this stage here, when you're talking Sweet 16 at this level, I wouldn't necessarily say the pressures, but the media is so big at that level. You're talking Indiana, Tula. You know, we're actually four programs that have been in it for a long time, have done it at a high level. So it'd be a lot of exposure. And I don't think there's anything wrong with it. You worked hard to get to this point, this part of it. Just continue to stay humble, stay hungry. But those are things we talk about from day one, so it's not like we give them a speech on how to be humble today. That's every day, and that's our approach. And we'll still do the things we need to do to be successful.
They, Mizzou, probably when they have Ross at the four position, not when he's at the three, but when he's at the four, because now they spread you out and really attack the rim and make plays. So very similar to Mizzou when they have Ross at the four. I think what it helped more than anything was the focus and taking care of the task at hand. It's the only thing we can control, and we talk about it every day as a staff, but the only thing we can control right now is what's presented to us, and we got to do everything in our power to try to win this particular game, and then the next game, get ready for that one. So I think that was more of the case. But, and I just, you know, it's a one-game season, so to speak, every time you have one in front of you, and whatever happens, happens. And I said, if we don't win it, we don't win it. But let's go out there and play basketball. And let's not feel like we have the weight of the world on our shoulders just to win a basketball game. If it doesn't work out, it doesn't work out.
Chris, you guys have talked a lot during this stretch about, you know, it feels good to prove people who wrote them off wrong. I guess, have you noticed a sense of kind of people coming back on board and people saying, hey, you know, we're buying back in on this team? Have you experienced any of that buyback?
For me, you know, the great thing for me, I've had the same friends since I was 5 or 6 years old, and that hadn't changed. That's been consistent. Outside of that, everything is pretty much bonus as far as I'm concerned. But for our guys, again, these are things I talk about from day one in June and July. This is what might happen. How do you handle these situations? Stay even keeled. But there's nothing wrong with a pat on the back. But understand why you got to this point, how you got to this point. So, yeah, I mean, that's part of it. But again, I still don't get a lot of sleep. I mean, it doesn't change for me. My making sure these guys get up and go to class, continue to be successful off the court, and it never stops, and that's the way it is.
How many people were here the other night when you guys got back?
What do you say, Tom? Tom probably knew the exact number, so I guess about 100. But it was great, and our guys, they really enjoyed it, and they looked forward to it. I don't think they knew about it. I didn't know. But to see the fans out there, I thought it was great. I saw mostly students, yes.
Talk a little bit about Nick Stauskas and the problems that he presents.
Oh, very talented. And I think whenever he decides to leave college, I know Coach wanted him there for 4 years, but whenever he decides to leave, there's no doubt in my mind he'll play at the NBA level. You know, 6'6", can really shoot the ball, can put the ball on the floor. And I think, you know, watching him more last year, he's more of a catch and shoot, but now he puts the ball on the floor, make plays. He comes off the ball screen. Get around the rim, he'll dunk the ball on you, go over the top of you, makes decisions out of that ball screen. I mean, I guess that's why he's a Big Ten Player of the Year in a league that's so tough and so physical, but very talented. That'd be a tall order because he can do a lot of things with the basketball.
How important is Jordan Morgan?
Well, very, very. I recruited Jordan when I was at Purdue as an assistant coach. Good basketball player, great family. I had an injury last year. I think he set out quite a bit, but a guy that has a good feel for the game, understanding of the game, grew up in Michigan, but a good defender, knows how to read defenses, dives off ball screens very well, scores when you have opportunities, but just a good leader for their program.
Is it safe to say that you guys, the way you've been playing lately, is as much quote unquote Big Ten basketball as what Michigan plays, if not more so, just kind of the style of the two traditional bigs?
Well, if Big Ten is physical, hard nosed, then if that's what it is, then that's what we play. But that's who we are. Because I think that's the way you can win ball games. You got to be able to go inside. They're winning big ball games, making shots, scoring. And everybody has their own style. But for us, we got to pound it inside, keep our spacing on the perimeter, make timely three-point shots, attack the rim. But it got to go through our bigs.
Coach, I'm sure you probably get 8 million questions on this coming up this week. But how does that make you feel going to this one? He's a name guy.
I want to beat him up. He's a great kid. I mean, his family's done a great job raising him. Happy for him. Happy to see the success he's having. It is. I mean, it's great to see for him.
Do you have a relationship with him?
Yes. Oh, yes. Don't want to see him play well on Friday, but he's a good kid, and he deserves everything he gets. Yeah, I mean, it's funny because, you know, and one of my buddies brought it up, one of my former teammates said, you know, in 94, we had to go to Michigan to win the Big Ten Conference because we didn't have a tournament then. And then, you know, obviously Glenn played well there. Glenn and I, 94, played in the NCAA tournament here in Knoxville. So I just, end of the day, put that ball in the basket. Tennessee tried to find a way to win the game. I hadn't talked to him since they had an event in West Lafayette. They retired his number. I think it might have been, I can't remember who Purdue might have played, Michigan State. So it was the last time I talked to him, yeah. Well, it doesn't really change for us because they'll go big when he's out there on the floor. And I think for us, just keeping pressure on the ball, keeping guys in front of us, and playing the way we're playing. And I think that's the biggest key. I don't think you change a lot of what you do when you get to this point. You can tweak and you scout your game plan. You find ways to win the ball game. But I don't think it changed much for us because they put a guard down and post up one of our smaller guys. We'll front the post and we'll make the adjustments. I mean, a talented team, and you can't take anything away from Iowa or UMass. I think those games we played well. Same way with Mercer. It's just unfortunate. I don't think Mercer will get – well, maybe they will since they beat Duke. But maybe if they hadn't played Duke and we'd have beat them, then there would have been questions. But Mercer's a really good team, a team that executes as well as anybody in the country as far as their offensive efficiency. But Michigan's a very talented team. But I think at this point they're all good. And it's what you do, who impose their will, and finding ways to win games down the stretch. Well, I didn't know that part, but again, I've said it before. He's a guy that watches a lot of film studies, get the DVDs. But again, a guy that, and I said it earlier, it's good and it's bad. He's a guy that listens to what people say, and he takes that and it motivates him to become a better basketball player. And I think as a young guy, you have to be strong enough to embrace that and handle that because some it's probably tough to deal with. And, you know, some guys can crumble, you know, hearing some of the things that are said about him. But I'm glad he's able to do that and because he's really improved his game on both ends of the floor. And I was happy to hear Langston Hall when he said about our ball screen defense, how a year ago they ripped us apart, and the way we made the adjustments, and really mainly Jarnell and one other guy in that position, but Jarnell made the adjustments defensively. So just happy for him, because again, he does listen to and he wants to be a good player. I just think that's Josh. And again, he can go out in Michigan and have 6 points, but still play a good game. But when he's aggressive and the shots are falling, then he's a different player. And we like for him to stay aggressive. But again, it's at his own pace if he feels comfortable out there. As I know as a player, sometimes, you know, coach wanted me to shoot the ball, and I wasn't as assertive early in my career to shoot the ball. But it's just it's how he's feeling. And if the shots are going, he's aggressive, then he's going to be extremely tough to defend. Well, I'm happy for him because he's a guy that wants to be a good player. He's a quality young man. His family's done a great job in raising him, but just happy to see him be successful, and he's making those strides. But I think what he's done, he's improved his leadership skills, and I think that was hard for him at first to try to be a leader, because as a leader, sometimes you're stepping on guys' toes, and that's not an easy thing to do. But I think that's where he's improved that.
How do you improve your leadership skills?
I just think over time, paying attention to detail, not being afraid to say certain things that you think certain guys might not want to hear you. I mean, because at the end of the day, and like I talked to him about it, when you want to win, is that if that's the most important thing, then whatever you're saying is right. And I said, you know, most of the guys in the locker room should follow you if it's right. And I think that's probably the biggest key with him, in my opinion, just not being afraid to say some things. I said, you can keep it the way it's going right now, or you can step up and lead. Well, I think we as a coach, what I do, I coach a team on how to be leaders. But I also tell the guys, in order to be successful as a leader, somebody has to follow. Because you have to know what it means to lead. You got to be able to follow first and understand how to lead. And that's what I talk about, because I don't think everybody can be a leader. Jarnell Stokes' case, he's a leader, but he's not very vocal. He's one of those guys pull you to the side. Jerron Maimon is a guy, he'll sit in front of everybody. And everybody has their own style. Different approach, but the results, you know, are the same.
Coach, how much of the glare that your guys play when you think is a result of after Tuesday's win? I mean, they just felt like it was, they had nothing to lose.
I think it was great to get that win against Iowa. Now let's play basketball. But I do think it was nerves the first 10 minutes of that game. Just, man, we in the NCAA tournament. It seems like guys were looking like, okay, you shoot it. Okay, what are we doing? You get the shot. We didn't flow right defensively. We lost assignments. And then once we settled down and especially got that thing in overtime, we started to play well, and we've been playing well ever since.
Coach, with your ties to Purdue, is it more special to bring a team back to that safe
Sweet 16? I went to school there. It's a great place. I learned a lot. One of my best friends is still the coach there. But outside of that, I work for the University of Tennessee, and that's the most important thing for me, to try to win a ball game. I got a lot of buddies that, you know, I play with still live in Indianapolis. So Indianapolis more so, just because of my friends. I stayed in Indianapolis, you know, 14 years of my life. But at the end of the day, we're trying to win a ball game. I didn't, to be totally honest with you. Just out of respect for their league, and that's the truth. And some people probably wouldn't believe it, but I didn't, because it's the same thing. If somebody called me and wants some information on Kentucky or Florida, I just respect I can't do it because they're in our league. But I didn't. I really didn't. I got a crook in my neck. Nah, it's fun. It was fun. My second boss, it was his idea.
Did you ever take one before?
No, I hadn't. I didn't. And really, I was like, man, what is a selfie? I mean, just, and I don't know if I'm that played out. I don't know. But it was fun.
You've never taken one
before? Is that when you take a picture of yourself?
Yeah.
No, I didn't. Now, my daughter, she's taking 1,000 of them, but not me.
Not to
fire back at the people who are angry? And number two, how have you coached your players on how to do that? Because it's got to be hard to fire back on Twitter for us.
Well, I think the thing for me, and my mom taught me this early in life, and I didn't understand it at the time. She just said, if you don't have anything nice to say, don't say anything at all. So that's why I'm quiet a lot of times, you know. And I just, no, but I mean, really, it's a sport and it's a business at the end of the day. And we talk about guys going to school and get degrees and all that. And for me, that's very important. But it seems for some that the bottom line is winning ball games. And there's nothing wrong with that. But I think as a coach, you got to keep in perspective. What's your goal? What's your plan for all your guys? Not every one of our guys will be pros. But they can be successful in their careers. And that's my job to help them with that. But I don't get consumed with what goes on because it's time and energy wasted. And if you can't control it, why worry about it? And at the end of the day, I don't care how successful you are. Some people won't like you for whatever reason. So why waste time on it? And one thing I've always lived by, unless they change something, there'll only be one body in that casket when I'm gone. It's the most important thing. Well, it's definitely a concern with this team. And I guess when you get to this point, you're playing against the best. And the margin for error is very slim. They shoot it very well. We got to contest that line. But the thing about it, when you get them off the line, they can make plays off the dribble. And they run their plays. And it's almost like you like for them to score, try to score out of their set plays, because when the set plays break down, they got four guys that can take you off the dribble and make plays and can make shots. So that's the biggest thing. And we talked about it, and I think it was good for us to play against a Mercer team that run those sets of space and a good three-point shooting team. Because the thing we talked about against Mercer, you have to limit the rotations. If you're constantly rotating against a Mercer and then it's a Michigan team, it's going to be a long night for you. So really limit the rotation. So the one-on-one defense has to be really good for us. So you're saying for us throwing it inside?
No, I'm saying, is it going to test your guys' buy-in to that theory? If they're playing against a team that's going to shoot a lot of threes, how important is it that they don't try to keep up with that and stick to the game
and
throw inside?
Well, I think, one, the whistle will blow and then somebody will be coming in and out of the game if that happens. But again, it's the reason why we got here. And you have to go through your guys. But on the perimeter, you got shots. You got to let them fly. I mean, you're not playing hesitant basketball. You got to play your game. But it's not a back-and-forth race. That's what they do. They do that consistently, and they're built on that. For us, we scored on the prem. I mean, Jordan's one of the best scorers in the game. You want him to score, but you still got to be able to get the ball inside, whether it's with the post feet off the dribble. You got to get it to the rim.
You guys are really shooting a ton of free throws compared to your NCAA tournament opponents. How much of your success hinges on how a game is called in the low post?
Well, for me, I feel like Jarnell gets fouled every time down there. I really do. And I'm not saying that to say any officials are bad. I'm not saying that. But I think he gets fouled every time down. Because he's so big and his lower body is so strong, you don't move him. Sometimes they don't make the call. But I think in the NCAA tournament, the calls are being made more so than probably in other settings. But he's such a physical guy. And I tell officials all the time, a foul is a foul. It doesn't matter if a guy's 5 feet tall and he bumps him. Just because he doesn't move him, it's still a foul. Not at all. And you know, leaving Dayton to go to Raleigh, we were excited. You know, we won a game. Didn't matter what the schedule was. We were happy to play a tournament game to move on. But not at all. It's been good so far.
Just fly in, right?
Yes.
Coach.
Thank you,
guys.
Thank you.